We just pulled this brick of yeast out of the freezer, and it has been there, as you can see, since 2008. The real question is it still going to make my bread rise?
Hi, I'm Kylene, and I'm the Provident Prepper. The yeast in this jar has been sitting in the bottom of my freezer in its original packaging since 2008. It was originally packaged in 2007, which means that this yeast is 13 years old. What do you think? Can you still bake delicious bread with it? Absolutely. In this video, I'll teach you which variety of yeast you should store for long-term storage and exactly how you should store it for optimal results.
Bread has been called the staff of life, and in our food storage, we store wheat so that regardless of what happens, we will be able to have bread for our family. But today we're going to talk about an important component of making bread, and that is instant yeast. Not all instant yeast has a long shelf life. If your intent is to be able to store yeast long term, you need to select a specific variety of yeast. The best one that we have found is Saf Red Instant Yeast. Sometimes it might be called Saf Red Yeast. It is sold in these vacuum sealed foil pouches that weigh a pound. Each one of these little yeast bricks have the potential to make about 96 loaves of bread. One of the great things about Saf Instant Yeast, in addition to the long shelf life, is that it doesn't require any proofing or dissolving. You can just add the yeast directly to the dry ingredients. Now, the recommended shelf life for Saf Instant Yeast is actually only about 2 years. As you can see on the back of this package, it was produced in November of 2007, and the best buy date is November of 2009. It is now 2020, which means that this yeast is about 13 years old. Now, as you can see, I purchased the yeast in 2008. For the longest shelf life, you should store the yeast in your freezer. I usually keep several packages of this Saf Instant Yeast. I like to store it all the way down at the very bottom of the freezer so that it isn't affected by the freezer door opening and closing and people rummaging through it. It just has this nice constant temperature at the very bottom of my freezer. Now, as you can tell, it feels like it's a brick because it's vacuum sealed. But as soon as you take the scissors and snip off the edge of that package, instantly it turns soft and kind of granulated as soon as that vacuum seal has been compromised. Once I open this Saf yeast, I pour it into a canning jar and put a plastic lid on it, and I store it in my refrigerator. I have had this yeast store in my fridge for at least a year and still be viable. Recommended shelf life really doesn't matter much, right? It's what the actual shelf life is. You may find that as yeast gets older, sometimes it just won't raise as well or as quickly. I pulled that Saf yeast out of my freezer this morning. And on the left, you can see the fresh dough that I had just mixed up. And on the right, that's only 20 minutes later and it has already doubled in size. I'm not sure how long the Saf yeast would remain viable in the bottom of my freezer, but I know that I've had some that was over 15 years old when I used it. Yeast doesn't really ever go bad. Sometimes old yeast will die and it won't raise your bread. It is easy to proof your yeast to ensure that it's still viable. Just take 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 tablespoon of yeast, and 1/4 cup of warm water and mix it together in a bowl. Within a couple minutes, you should see some nice healthy bubbles forming just like this. If you don't want to store instant yeast, there is quite frankly a healthier alternative. And sometimes it's referred to as sourdough, natural yeast, or wild yeast. And you can make bread simply out of water, salt, and that natural yeast. If you click the card in the corner, it will take you to a post that I created, especially on this subject. Quite frankly, I love the taste of the sourdough bread. Some of my family doesn't like it as much and they prefer the instant yeast. Now with the sourdough starter, it's important to remember that it's alive and it's full of these healthy probiotic bacteria that rapidly grows and multiplies. So it's much healthier for your body, but it also must be fed. It will die very quickly if you don't continue to take care of it. This is my all-time favorite sourdough bread. It has red peppers, roasted garlic, and parmesan, and then it's got some toasted sesame seeds on the top, and it really is quite delicious. And you can't get that flavor with instant yeast. However, instant yeast is so much quicker. I told you that I pulled that yeast out of the bottom of the freezer this morning, and by noon today, my family was devouring this bread. Hot homemade bread has a way of magically disappearing in our household. I had intended on taking a picture of the loaves of bread outside of the bread pans, but somehow that smell of hot baked bread reached all my little vultures here, and they devoured it before I could ever get a picture of one whole loaf. But the take-home message from today's video is, if you buy the right kind of yeast, which SAF instant yeast is perfect, and you store it correctly, which means in the bottom of a freezer, that yeast can make incredibly delicious bread for at least 13 years and possibly even up to 20. If you're interested in making bread from natural yeast, you might want to visit the Provident Prepper and check out the post Incredible Survival and Daily Bread Using Only Wheat, Salt, and Water. Another video that might interest you is Enemies to Food Storage. Now, in this video, we talk about shelf-stable ingredients. Yeast can stay on the shelf for a little while, but there is no way that you are going to get the long 13-plus year shelf life if you are storing this in your storage room on a shelf. It needs to go into the freezer. And another video that is really interesting is how old is too old? You have accumulated all these wonderful stores of food, and sometimes we don't rotate through them as well as we might ought to. And so how do we know exactly how old is too old? And this video does a great job of addressing that.
Bet you didn't know 13-year-old yeast could make something this delicious.
That's almost as old as he is.
The goal is always to use fresh foods, but we're pretty happy with old yeast.
And now for the question of the day. What is your favorite food to make with basic food supplies? Comment below. And thanks for being part of the solution. Clink, clink, clink.
Mmm. No meat.